Hello students, in this session we are going to learn optimal binary search tree. We have learnt in detail what is binary search tree. In the binary search tree, the elements are stored such that every node has in its left subtree the element lesser than the root, and in the right subtree all the elements greater than the root. And this is followed, this property is followed by each and every node in that tree. Now, we have seen or implemented also the searching function in the binary search tree. The complexity of searching function in the binary search tree, it depends on the height of the tree that we have seen. Because in every level, the comparison will be done with only one node. Okay. So, the elements which are present near the root will be searched in the faster way than the elements which are stored near the leaf. So, the first thing is the complexity of searching, it depends on the height of the tree. Second thing is the position of the element which we are searching, that also is required, or that also impacts the searching complexity. If the element is stored near the root, or if it is the root, if the element to be searched is the root, it will be searched in big O of one time. Whereas if the element is present near the leaf, then it can tend to, the searching will tend to big O of n. Okay. So, in order to minimize the complexity of searching, if the tree is a static tree, that is, no more insertions and deletions will be performed, then we have seen that multiple binary search trees are possible from the given data. If the data is given, for the same data we can have multiple binary search trees available. Then which one is the better binary search tree out of that? So the binary search tree created will depend on the sequence of insertion of those elements. And thus the different various binary search trees will be created. So we have to select any one which is better binary search tree, which will give us the lesser searching complexity in that BST. So we will study optimal binary search tree, which is the tree which is calculated or which is found based on the less cost of that BST. Okay. So here we want to perform lookup operations by building a BST. Lookup operation is for searching with words as keys and their equivalent as satellite data. So we want to create the symbol table using the OBST. We can ensure log n search time per occurrence by using red and black tree, which is a balanced binary search tree. Okay, so if it is a balanced binary search tree, then we can ensure that the searching time is log n. Okay, a frequently used word may appear far from root, while a rarely used word appears near the root. So if this is so, this will increase the searching complexity for every word. So, frequently used words, they should appear near the root so that they will be searched faster. We want frequent words to be placed near the root. So, in order to organize a BST so as to minimize the number of nodes visited in all the searches, we can go for the OBST. So, these are the two sample BSTs generated from the same data. So, the keys are same in the both BSTs, K1 to K5. Okay. So, K2 is the root in both and K1 is the left subtree, and K3, K4, K5 are arranged in the right subtree. So, we have to select now better BST. With the first appearance, it seems that second BST is costlier than the first BST, as first BST is somewhat more balanced than the second BST. That's why to the first appearance, second BST looks costlier, and first we will prefer the first BST. Now, what are these D0 to D5 nodes? These are the dummy nodes which are searched, in the BST. So K1 to K5 are the successful nodes, whereas D0 to D5, they are the dummy nodes or failure nodes. So for example, D1, it is the value, any value between K1 to K2. Okay. D2, it is any value between K2 to K3. So these are the failure nodes. Now, we have to select which is the better BST. So, OBST, it is one of the special kind of advanced tree which focuses on reducing the searching cost. So, here precondition is it should have static set of elements, that is addition and deletion of elements will not be done, and cost of searching, it depends on the height of the tree. So, we may not have the lowest height, but the elements which are frequently accessed, they should be present near the root. Okay. So, to find out which is the better BST, we will take, so this is the structure of these trees where K1 to Kn are stored as the keys, and D0 to Dn, they are dummy nodes. So, this is also input to us the probabilities of successful nodes and probabilities of failure nodes, and addition of all these probabilities will be 1. Okay. So we have probabilities of searches for each key and each dummy key. So we will be creating one table from these probabilities. These probabilities are found based on the occurrence. Suppose these keys are nothing but the keywords which we are using in our program. So, based on the analysis done, we can find the probability of searching for any one keyword. So, these probabilities are based on that analysis. So, PI. It is probability of searching, this K1 is 0.15, probability of searching K2 is 0.10, like that. These are the successful nodes probabilities, whereas QI is probability of failure nodes, searching the failure nodes. So, in order to search all D0 elements, we have this probability 0.05, like that. So, these probabilities are given. And now we have to decide which one is the better BST out of these two. So we will be creating one table, which is depth of a node, probability of searching that node, and cost of searching that node. So we will use this formula, cost is equal to probability into depth plus 1. So if we see, this table is created for first tree where the depth of K2 is 0, K1 and K4 is 1, and K3, K5 is 2. So, these depths are written, and for D0, D1 also, we are writing the depth. And probability is 0.15, 0.10. These are all given. These are successful probabilities and these are failure probabilities. Then cost of searching each node is found based on this formula, probability into depth plus 1, cost of searching of each node, and finally we will add these costs to find the cost of the BST. So finally the cost of that first BST is 2.80. Similarly, we will create the similar table for the second BST, and so here height of these nodes will vary, that is depth will vary, the probability will remain same and cost will change because depth is modified. So if we create the same table, we will find that the second BST, it will have cost 2.75, which is better than the first BST. So the first appearance is not telling us which is the proper BST, but the cost calculated will tell us which is better BST. So in this second BST, what happens? The nodes which are accessed frequently, that is K5, which is accessed more times, it is placed near the root. Okay, it is placed near the root, and the nodes which are accessed less times, that is K3, it is stored far from the root. Okay, so we have compared only two BSTs. There can be other better BST than this also with the same keys, okay, which we can generate based on this. Okay, so we can create the same table for another BST and find out its cost and select the proper BST. Okay, so you can solve another example where keys are given and successful failure probabilities are given. Two trees are given, out of that you have to find which is the better BST, okay, which is OBST, that you have to find out. So with this, we have completed the OBST concept. Okay, thank you.